This is the solution to written homework 39. Okay, so the question in the end, to rephrase in plain language, what's being asked? Which money flow has the greater future value? So whichever one has the greater future value, that's the one that you want. In 10 years' time, which is the only time that you have access to the money, you just want whichever happens to be greater. Okay, so option one. Option one. Well, the future value is, so it will be exponential. So before I compute the future value, I'm going to compute the present value. So the present value of option one is integral 0 to 10, and since it's a 7% rate and that's the flow, it'll be exponential negative 0.07t multiplied by 3000t plus 100 dt. So in order to evaluate this, we'll have to do it by parts. So u will be the algebraic part, so 3000 t plus 100 dv is the exponential part. Du is 3000 dt. And V is exponential negative 0.07t divided by negative 0.07. So then the right-hand side of by parts would be 3000 t plus 100 times that value times that negative 0.07t divided by negative 0.07, and then evaluate it from 0 to 10, and then minus integral 0 to 10 of v du. Well, du is a constant and v is that. So I'm going to go ahead and spend that negative and make it plus, spending that negative there. And then that would be 3000 over 0.07, which is just a constant, exponential negative 0.07t dt. So as for this evaluation here, so I'll go ahead and evaluate it now. Okay, so plugging all that in. So negatives, no, sorry. 1 over 0, negative 0.07. Okay, then times. Three thousand times 10 plus 100 times the exponential of negative 0.07 times 10 and then minus 3,000 times 0 plus 100 times the exponential of 0, which is 1. Okay, does that look good? Okay, so this first number here is how much? Negative 212103.1092. So that first one became that one, and then minus now, because we're going to get that division by that constant one more time, so that'd be 3,000 over 0.07, but we have two of them, so it'll be squared, and then exponential negative 0.07 t evaluated from 0 to 10. Okay, so then this will be negative 212103.1092 minus, okay, how much? Okay. So that will be 3,000 divided by 0.07 squared times exponential of negative 0.07 times 10 minus the exponential of 0, which is 1. So minus negative, how much is that? 308,213.0793. Adding those two together, you get 96,111.97011. Okay, so that means that the present value of the first option is $96,000 ish. So the future value option one, that number is the exponential of 0.07 times 10 years multiplied by that number. Okay, and that's equal to how much? Exponential 0.07 times 10 times 96,111.97011. Okay, so that's 193,545.74. Okay, so this is the first outcome. So that's the future value of option number one. It's saying that if we were to take option number one, the payout would be $193,000. Okay, so for option two, its present value is given by the integral 0 to 10 exponential negative 0.06 t multiplied by 3200 t plus 100 dt. So now we need to evaluate that integral. Again, this will be done by parts. So, in particular, we'll take u as the algebraic part. So 3200 t plus 100 dv is everything else. Therefore, du is 3200 dt, and v is exponential negative 0.06 t divided by negative 0.06. So then the right-hand side of that integral is 3200 t plus 100, that's u, times v, exponential negative 0.06 t over negative 0.06, and then this evaluated from 0 to 10. And then to that, we'll have to add an integral. So, it'll be minus integral v du, but v has this negative, so I'll make it plus integral 0 to 10, and then 3200 over 0.06 du. So then exponential negative 0.06 t dt. Okay, so now I'll evaluate this first part. Times 10 plus 100 times the exponential of negative 0.06 times 10, and then minus 3200 times 0 plus 100 times the exponential of 0, which is 1. Okay, so this first value here is negative 291 947, no, not point, negative 291,947, and then point 5586, 5586, that's that first value. And then now, performing that integral, minus 3200 over 0.06 squared, exponential of negative 0.06 t, and then from 0 to 10. Okay, so this would be negative 291,947.5586. Okay, now evaluate this. So that'd be minus some number that I'll write in here. 3200 divided by 0.06 squared times, so exponential negative 0.06 times 10, and then minus exponential of 0, which is 1. So that would be negative 401,056 dollars, 3235. So 0.3235. So adding those two numbers together, you get 109,108 dollars and 7649 is the fractional part. So this is the future value of the second option. Okay. Well, therefore, the choice is obvious. Therefore, choose option 1. Because it has the greater future value. By a great deal, actually.